Welcome back to The Wolf Among Us, starting episode 3.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow.
She's alive!
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
Crane. Ichabod Crane. I knew it.
That motherfucking piece of shit.
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person.
Exactly what I would have said.
You have to tell her.
I know.
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
Crane's the killer.
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things
a long pause.
She doesn't talk about. Just, please be careful.
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
What are we doing? Dumpsters?
Lily had many friends, but few fables she was
the snow?
Close to.
Snow! In danger!
If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for.
You gonna wave or what? You didn't even
I
wave.
Won't offend you by claiming one day that the
what
pain
is?
Of losing Lily will ever subside.
Your Highness.
I know as well as
Sheriff.
Guy that we saved.
Sorry,
did you know the deceased? Lily?
No, not really. I just
looking a little less dead.
I don't know. Felt like the thing I should do, I guess. I was angry at first when I heard that Lily was getting a funeral. And Holly was getting closure. I wanted that too.
Stubborn
and I wanted it for Faith, but then I remember Faith lived a story Lily never did. She had her adventure. She got to live in the light of forever after with me, for a while. So let Lily have a better finish. It all evened out.
I'm gonna get the guy who did this, Lawrence. Good
times. Thank you, Bigby. I never met. And thanks for saving my life. What I've been told. Take care of
them. You're welcome.
Okay.
I know in my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight.
I have money.
And now we'll have our moment of silence. Thank you.
Offering table?
I'll miss worrying about you. I'll miss our fights. I'll miss you, Holly.
Bigby, is everything okay?
No.
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here? After you lie, and you say you need her for evidence?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it.
Yeah. I wonder why.
I'm telling you the
truth. Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being...
Crane did it. Crane did it.
This
just yell it out.
On him.
Crane did it. Crane did it.
Why are you here, anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
Crane did it. Crane did it.
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else?
What? No, I deserve to know. We all deserve to know.
Crane did it. Crane did it.
I know, but this isn't the way to go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way.
Crane,
I think it
Crane.
Was Ichabod Crane.
What?
Crane.
Crane.
Okay, everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while
Crane
everyone else gets back to the funeral.
What? He says that fucking Crane murdered Lily and you expect me to...
Please, I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first. Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Yeah, whatever.
Of course. I won't even know I'm here.
Let's discontinue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
Crane.
Yeah.
I can't believe this. This is someone I've worked with for decades. This is a guy... He gets frickin' shakes when he has to order food. I mean, what are you telling me? It's all an act? Just, what have you found?
Picture.
Bigby?
Snow, Crane is completely obsessed with you.
Oh my god, if this is about how Crane treats me at work...
Just listen to me for a second, alright? I followed
Just
a lead
the
to
fucking
this
picture.
Shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. He replays your story over and over again.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I thought that Crane might be looking for you. I thought you might be in trouble.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing?
Where's the picture?
Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. You took a cab here, right?
Yeah.
I'll drive. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
It's just that something's come up.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
As long as Crane's not here, we're good.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything?
It was Crane's room. But you knew that already, right?
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable?
Wait, easy now, girl.
Who that?
You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do?
Now is really not the time for whatever you Jergovs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere.
Working for Crane?
Did he send you?
No. See now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours? Brother?
You think this act you got going scares me? Cause it doesn't.
Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy. Really. That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
Ah, get him!
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly?
Think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Get him.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love. Things don't have to turn sloppy now. Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead
hole. Let her kill him.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
Motherfucker.
I got it, damn.
Crap.
Snow!
Oh no. I forgot how to work the Q button again. Oh god damn it. I thought I was getting the replay. Episode 3, A Crooked Mile.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart.
I can't take it easy. I have to find Crane.
Bigby? What's wrong?
Lack of sleep for one thing, getting shot for another. He'll be fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
Look, I'm not the one who creates the situations. I'm just the one who has to deal with them.
So you say.
Yeah, that's what I say.
Business office. I know, I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters.
Nah.
That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't
wait
know.
For the mirror.
That's the plan? Just... wait for the mirror?
It's all we have right now. What the hell is going on? Just... I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but... do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women?
He killed them. And he sent Dee and Dumb to slow me down.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts.
Yeah.
But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by
only
the way.
I cut myself. Nothing to
that
worry about.
That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
I just can't fucking stand that they got away.
We'll catch up to them, Bigby. You did enough.
I'm gonna kill him.
Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And
sure.
I don't want to offend you.
Sure.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside,
what?
You kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives
you
an
about?
Excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
Guys? We have
What's
a problem.
Up?
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Yeah.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Crane took
yes, it. Yes, it's,
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
The mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take.
We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
All right. How long will it take for the mirror to reform?
Well, it could take days.
Or months, or years. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Talk to the flying monkey.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
Why didn't you try and stop him?
What do you want me to do, yank on his hair? I'm only 3 feet tall. There are limits here.
Okay, okay.
You can fly. Drop something on him.
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
What's that mean?
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, all right?
You mean it?
Yeah. No.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that. Buffkin says that he overheard Crane call somebody before he left. Sounds like he's going to see a witch, or his witch. His glamour witch.
Wait, really? None of the 13th floor witches would allow that sort of thing. They must be somewhere in the city. It's something, at least.
Find anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Maybe check that stuff there.
What stuff? Where are you going? Gonna take the long way around? I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning. It's burning up. And Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I really like it if you'd fix the air like we asked you 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. You said you'd pay to have the plaster redone in my building after last incident in 204. It's falling off the fucking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention, you already promised me that you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together, Mr. Toad. I don't know who Waylon Smith is, except for on Simpsons. Are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Best, Waylon Smith.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Key.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
Too late. Where'd he got in?
You still haven't told me what was in there.
Blood.
I want to know.
A lot of blood and flowers.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
We'll get him.
Don't worry, Snow. We'll get him.
Come on, let's keep looking.
Locked. Break it.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Yeah, I only recently heard about this meeting. Why didn't you mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, nope. This isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called
I
me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried
this
to,
isn't
but...
isn't your concern.
No, it can't be fixed. It's missing a piece.
This is none of Bluebeard's business, Bigby.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Uh-huh. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so he can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
If he didn't do it, he knows who did.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
What do you know about Crane, anyway?
That he has the stones to kill prostitutes like any common sex-frightened serial killer and not face a real challenge.
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. Put you in charge in the first place.
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
You're
thing.
You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you are chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
Who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Get out, freak.
All right, let's just... Look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Do both.
Look, chances are I'll have to swing by both anyways.
No, chances are you won't have time.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
Sure I can.
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock.
Break it down.
I wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest.
Just go ahead and get out.
Crime scene.
Fine, I don't care. Just go ahead.
We can't just let Bluebeard run amok in Crane's place.
Ha!
He's after something. I just don't know what it is. We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it.
I'm like, fine.
So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
Where am I going?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.